Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Thank you for the time has given to us. We are from group 9 and today we will present to you about lifelong learning. Okay. I am Carmila Sari and I am the first speaker. Okay, I will explain to you about definition of learning. The concept of lifelong learning, and the third is characteristic of lifelong learning. Okay, the first is definition of learning. The following understanding of learning according to expert among others, the first is, according to Winkle, learning is all mental or psychological activity that takes place in active interaction in the environment, which result in change in the management of understanding. Jadi, menurut Winkle, belajar adalah semua aktivitas mental atau psikis yang berlangsung dalam interaksi aktif dalam lingkungan yang menghasilkan perubahan-perubahan dalam pengelolaan pemahaman. And the second is, according to Ernest R. Hilgard, learning is a process of action carried out deliberately which then causes change, which is different from the change caused by others. Jadi menurut Ernest R. Hilgard, belajar merupakan proses perbuatan yang dilakukan dengan sengaja yang kemudian menimbulkan perubahan yang keadaannya berbeda dari perubahan yang ditimbulkan oleh lainnya. And the third is, Hilgard believes learning is the process by which an activity originates as change through training procedures, whether in the laboratory or in the natural environment. Jadi Hilgard berpendapat, belajar adalah proses yang melahirkan atau mengubah suatu kegiatan melalui jalan latihan, apakah dalam laboratorium atau dalam lingkungan alamiah. And the second is, the concept of lifelong learning. Lifelong learning is the concept of continuous from the cradle to the end of life in line with the phases of development in humans. This educational process includes forms of learning in an informal, non-formal, and formal manner, both in the family, at school, in work, and in community life. Jadi, lifelong learning atau belajar sepanjang hayat adalah konsep tentang belajar terus-menerus dan berkesinambungan atau continuing learning dari lahir sampai akhir hayat, sejalan dengan fase-fase perkembangan pada manusia. Nah, proses pendidikan ini mencakup bentuk-bentuk belajar secara informal, non-formal, maupun formal, baik yang berlangsung dalam keluarga, di sekolah, dalam pekerjaan, dan dalam kehidupan masyarakat. For Indonesian itself, the conception of lifelong education through state policy, tab MPR number 4, MPR 1970, tab nomor 4, MPR 1978 about GBHN, which sets out the principle of national development among others. And the third is the characteristic of lifelong learner. Knowledge possessed by someone will be reflected in their attitudes and actions, as well as through learner lifelong, according to Aikenberry 2007. There are several characteristics that are generally owned by lifelong learners, namely, the first is, have an organized mindset. In carrying out activities including learning, we must have thoughts with an expert. These thoughts will provide a great opportunity to master science. Jadi, ilmu yang dimiliki oleh seseorang akan tercermin dalam sikap dan perbuatannya. Begitu juga lifelong learner sejati. Jadi, menurut Aikenberry 2007, ada beberapa karakteristik yang secara umum dimiliki oleh lifelong learner, yaitu Yang pertama, memiliki pola pikir yang tertata. Jadi dalam melakukan kegiatan termasuk belajar, kita harus memiliki pola pikiran seperti seorang ahli. Nah, pikiran ini tersebut akan memberi peluang besar untuk menguasai ilmu pengetahuan. The second is make a relationship. In order for knowledge, the develop mastery of the relationship between information is needed. Jadi yang kedua itu membuat hubungan. Nah, agar pengetahuan dapat berkembang, maka diperlukan penguasaan pembuatan hubungan antara informasi yang satu dengan yang lain. And the third is flexible and can adapt well. Jadi yang ketiga itu flexible dan dapat beradaptasi dengan baik, and so on. I think enough for my explanation. Thank you for your attention. Wabillahi taufiq wal hidayah. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Thanks for the time he has given to me. My name is Nur Alim. I am from group 9 and I am second speaker. I am going to explain about basic objective and benefit of long life learning. Okay. Basic long life learning. The discussion on the concept of lifelong education is described in two parts, namely in terms of the theoretical or religious basis and the legal basis. Okay. Theoretical religious basis. The concept of lifelong education was originally put forward by the very famous American philosopher and educator John Dewey. Then popularized by Paul Langlet through his book, The First, An Introduction to Lifelong Education. According to John Dewey, education is one with life. Therefore, education continues throughout life so that education never ends. And two, basic juridical. And three, the concept of lifelong education in Indonesia began to be promoted through state policies, namely through. And four, MPR decree number 4, MPR 973, JOTAP number 4, MPR 978, concerning GBHN, stipulates the principles of national development, including 5. National development is carried out in the context of the development of Indonesian people as a whole and the development of all the people of Indonesia. And 6. Education lasts a lifetime and is carried out in the family, a school and community. Therefore, education is a shared responsibility between family, community and government. Okay, next. Tujuan long life learning. The first, developing the potential of the human personality in accordance with nature and its essence, namely all aspects of blending as optimal as possible. Second, by enhancing the process of growth and development of human personality that is dynamic is nature, education naturally lasts for a lifetime. Next, manfaat long life learning. The first, tinjauan ideologis. The second, tinjauan ekonomis. The third, tinjauan sosiologis. The fourth, tinjauan fisiologis. And five, tinjauan teknologis. And last, tinjauan psikologis dan pedagogis. Okay, next. Target long life learning. Lifelong learning can be done in the family environment, in formal education and informal, and in non-formal education. The first, lifelong learning in a family environment. The first pledge for learning for a human being is a family environment. At this stage, the most decisive stage for a child to start learning in his family. Second, lifelong learning in formal education. Long life learning informal education is systematic and planned learning. Having specific goals according to the talents, abilities or major that are of interest to the learner include informal education are from the level of kindergarten, elementary school, junior high school, senior high school, vocational high school, and etc. In formal education, after someone completes a high school or vocational school program, everyone is allowed to attend lectures in tertiary education, regardless of age, gender, and ethnicity or class. And the last, lifelong learning in non-formal education. Learning does not recognize age, time, and place anywhere. At any time, we can learn from this life. Learning does not have to be in school or formal education as well as a diploma. But learning can be anywhere from a variety of sources that contain knowledge. Many people learn muscle notes, but they are not successful. That people who have formal education. That means, is it not necessarily people with formal education can be more successful than people without formal education? Okay, I think enough for me. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Fetianti Opikasari. Well, I will continue our material about long life learning. Long life learning process. The stage of human learning basically consists of two parts. The first part is the learning process that cannot be seen by the five senses. Because the learning process occurs in the mind of someone who is doing learning activities. This process is often referred to as an internal process. The second part is called the external learning process. This process can show whether in a person there has been a learning process that is marked by a change for the better. Next, learning obstacles. Some conditions that are not conducive indeed do not directly affect a person's intelligence. However, if left unchecked, a person's potential can be uncovered in its entirety. To anticipate this, we must recognize several factors inhibiting the development of intelligence as well as ways to overcome them. The first, stress. Stress can be interpreted as physical and mental or emotional tension because the body responds to demands, pressures, and disturbances that surround it. Stress can be triggered by certain events other than due to environmental influence. You could say the stress itself is like a knife half. The way of learning revolution. The first, reposition the role of electronic communication in the world of education. The second, learn computers and the internet. Improve totally education for parents, especially new parents. Promote health service for children to prevent them from learning difficulties. Create a quality children's growth program for everyone. Implement missed teaching programs in each school. Discover individual learning styles and intelligence and serve each style. And the last, schedule for everyone. Learn about learning and thinking. Next, establishing independence. Every human being born in this world cannot directly live independently. At the beginning of his life, he will need help from others and even tend to depend on others. From infancy to children, he will need the role of family and those around him to help him survive. But as he grows, he will gradually be able to reduce his level of dependence on others, so that over time he can become an independent human being. So the conclusion about lifelong learning. Lifelong learning education is a system of educational concepts that explain the whole events of teaching and learning activities that take place in all human life. The process of lifelong learning takes place continuously and is not limited by time learned, but all levels of society can carry it out. The application of ways of thinking according to the principle of lifelong learning will change our view of the social status and function of the school, where the main task of school education is to teach students how to learn. I think enough thing about material lifelong learning. Thanks for your attention. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.